these last days of her teaching career were not spent in the classroom with her students as she had hoped, but instead social distancing from them and talking to them through a computer screen.
I had plans, you know, for the last 2 months of school. In my mind, I had plans of different, a lot of them were the same plans that I kind of do every year, but I had it planned in a bigger send-off kind of way.
When Kathy walked into her classroom on that Friday, she didn't realize it would be the last day she would be able to see her students in person.
So it was kind of hard when I went into my classroom the first time afterwards to start kind of going through making those packets and doing those things, and then realizing, look at all this stuff that I'm not going to be able to do. All these plans I had, and they're not going to be done.
The pandemic has also altered her plans for retirement, including traveling with her husband.
The big issue is there's just a lot of unknowns. So my husband and I thought about some different plans we might do when we retire. Now I think we don't know if those are going to be the right plans.
Although Kathy didn't get the proper send-off she deserves, she says the one thing that hurts her most is not being able to say goodbye to her students.
I miss them, and I'm hoping that we will all get to see each other real soon, and that life can, certainly I'm praying that life can get back to normal, or sort of back to normal for everyone.
In Twin Falls, I'm Stephanie Garibay, Idaho News 6.